Now it's time to go play with this bad girl. Once you do that, the phone is officially yours.
I'm officially an iPhone X owner.
Wow. What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, B-Mac. And the time has finally come. In front of me, I have the iPhone X. Just got home after picking this bad girl up from the Apple Store. So we're gonna unbox her. This is the 256GB Apple iPhone X space gray version. Quick look at the packaging. It's what you would expect from an Apple iPhone X. Cool, sleek packaging. They almost opened it up in the store to set it up for me. I'm like, no, no, no. Gotta bring it home. Gotta unbox it for my subscribers. You're welcome. Technically, I don't need the knife because they designed these to be able to peel it, so.
Sorry, buddy. Not today.
We have this nice little tab right here.
That first initial, oh.
The cellophane is off, it's official now. This is just a box, I'm just one picker upper away from seeing what's inside this thing. Let's just do it.
Deep breath.
Designed by Apple in California, that's good. Glad I got the right phone. I'm like shaking right now, here we go. Underneath this little tab right here.
There she is.
Pardon me, I'm just gonna take a second to admire her sleekness and sexiness. There she is, the Apple iPhone X, looking great. We have the edge-to-edge OLED display. I am yet to actually see this phone in person. I didn't even see it on display in the Apple Store. I just knew right away I wanted it. Placed the pre-order. This is the first time I'm seeing this phone in person. I might actually have a heart attack when I see the screen actually light up. Those OLED screens, baby. But let's continue with the unboxing. In this little first tab that we pulled out, this is your Hello Quick Start Manual.
Oh my gosh.
I actually am gonna have to read this Quick Start Manual because of the no home button on this new iPhone.
This is gonna take a little getting used to.
But anyway, that's your Quick Start Guide. You have your warranty and product information on that. And of course, it wouldn't be an Apple product without some Apple stickers. I'm still yet to decide what to do with my Apple stickers. Take a second to comment down below what you do with your Apple stickers when you get them, because I have like 40 that I do not know what to do with. I was gonna put them all in my car, but after about the 6th sticker, people think you have a problem. So I don't know what to do with them, but you get your stickers, you get your Quick Start Manual. Let's get to the phone itself. We're gonna pull this little tab. Oh, look at her. Feels amazing in my hand. I'm telling you, feels like God crafted this device specifically for my hand. Initially, feels great, feels very sleek. Has a good weight to it. And by good weight, I mean, you know, light, but not too light to the point where it feels like you're holding a feather. But also heavy enough to make you remember you have an expensive phone in your hand. So it feels good. We're gonna compare it with my iPhone 7 Plus later on in this video because that is a huge concern I had. We'll see if the little bit of a size difference makes a difference. But for now, back to the unboxing. Underneath the phone itself, of course you have your wall adapter for the charger, which you might not wanna use with the iPhone X because this is gonna slow down your charging capabilities quite substantially compared to what the iPhone X is actually capable of. We'll talk more about that later, but it comes with a wall adapter if you should choose to use that. And of course, you get your brand new pair of earbuds. But because of no headphone jack on the iPhone X, similar to the other recent iPhones, you also get your Lightning to 3.5 millimeter audio jack adapter. This little adapter comes in handy. I know it's kind of hidden there on the back of your AirPods, but do not lose this adapter if you want to be able to use pretty much any headphones with your iPhone X. Always nice to have a fresh new pair of earpods. They're not AirPods, they're earpods, unfortunately. Big difference there. These are the wired version of the AirPods, not the wireless AirPods that you probably heard a lot about. It comes with the wired Apple headphones. And of course, you get your Lightning to USB cable. This is what you're gonna use to connect your iPhone X to your computer or to charge it in the wall. Again, you might not wanna use this setup for charging your iPhone X because you could charge it faster with a different setup. And you could also wirelessly charge it because the iPhone X is capable of wireless charging. But you can't sell an iPhone without a way to charge it, so Apple gave those to you. And that's it for what comes in the box. That's the iPhone X. I'm like scared to put this down. I do not want any scratch on it. We'll move this out of the way and we'll put this right here. Okay, so this is the first time I'm gonna turn on the iPhone X and experience an OLED display on an iPhone. Let's do it. But first, let's take off the cellophane. Move the box out of the way so we get the full effect. I don't even wanna touch it. I don't even wanna lay a fingerprint on the back of this phone. I'm gonna do it anyway. So sleek. Ooh, let's turn it over. That's it. That's it. Once you do that, the phone is officially yours.
I'm officially an iPhone X owner.
Wow. Anyway, I need to turn her on, see what she looks like. Roll up my sleeves for this occasion. You just power on like you would any other iPhone by holding down the power button on the side. Let's do it. The anticipation. Okay, it went dark. What happened? Oh, it's there again. Scared me for a second there. Thought something was wrong.
No home button on this thing is real.
Oh man. That screen is absolutely
unreal.
It looks fake. It looks like a hologram is in the screen.
It looks fake.
I know this is just the welcome screen, but I've never seen anything like this on an iPhone before.
This screen is nuts.
So you can swipe up to open. I'm gonna do that now. There's no home button on this thing, which is actually confusing me a lot. But you swipe up to open. Let's do it. Right from the bottom. Oh. Just up like that. English. United States. Quick start. If you have an iPhone or iPad running iOS 11, bring it nearby to sign in automatically. My trusty iPhone 7 Plus, all smudged up with fingerprints. Let's bring her nearby. Turn her on. Oh, there it is. Set up new iPhone. This will transfer your current settings. Hold your new iPhone up to the camera. This is new. This is very similar to setting up your Apple Watch. I'm just looking at that screen, dude. I'm just looking at that screen. The detail and colors. I haven't even seen anything yet. All right, let's do this. Hold up your new phone to the camera. Wow, and just like that. Okay, right out of the box, the first thing I love the most that I actually found myself doing on my iPhone 7 Plus was tapping the screen to wake it up like you do on the Apple Watch. Look at that, that's dope. If she's silent, all I gotta do is just give her a little tap. And she lights up. Love that. But anyway, I can set up Face ID. This is all part of the setup process. I'll create a passcode, and I would normally restore from iCloud backup, but to show you guys a little bit of the phone itself, I'm just gonna set it up as a new phone. Just gonna agree to those terms and conditions. I'll just click continue on the express settings, set up everything later. That True Tone display is pretty cool, by the way. Basically, it'll change the colors, like the white balance you see on your phone, to match the ambient setting you're in. This is a great way to demonstrate that. We're in my unboxing setup here. Lots of white. Everything should be daylight balanced to 5500 Kelvin, but if I just press this button, see without True Tone display, that is crazy. You don't realize how much of a difference the True Tone display actually makes. Cool little subtlety there. Thought I should point that out. I'm just gonna click continue, continue, continue. We're just gonna swipe up to get started, and there we are. Here we are, iPhone 10 right in front of me. Now let's take a closer look at the device itself. So my biggest concern with this phone was the cutout, the notch at the top. That notch at the top, when I first saw this phone and they announced that, I'm like, why did we put a notch at the top? Why don't we just round the whole thing and call it a day? Now, this is mostly just because of the wallpaper that's currently on here, but I can't really tell a difference that the notch is there. If we go to something like Safari, now the notch is heavily present. But if I'm being honest, it's not as intrusive as I thought it was gonna be. If I'm in landscape mode, it's a little bit more obvious, especially if we go to a website. You know, I don't know about that notch. It's definitely gonna take some time to decide whether or not that notch on the iPhone 10 is gonna bother me or not. My guess is that, like most changes that Apple incorporates into their products, I'll probably get used to it, maybe come to appreciate it. I don't know, that might be pushing it, but we'll see about the notch. Right out of the box, doesn't seem like that big of a deal. The phone itself is very sleek, very sexy, very thin, and the side bezels are actually very shiny, very good looking. I know a lot of people were concerned about there being bezels on this phone. I actually think it feels really good in your hand. It feels very natural. So far, I'm liking it. But let's compare it to my beloved iPhone 7 Plus. Side by side, there's very clearly a difference in size, physical size between the two phones. But the thing to pay attention to is the screen. The screen technically is bigger in a way if you measure diagonally. But that landscape difference is something to consider. I already got fingerprints all over these things. Excuse the fingerprints. The iPhone 7 Plus just feels like a phablet type of phone in your hand. But the big thing to remember is that screen that pretty much covers the entire front face of the phone. The buttons match the stainless steel bezels right on the side here. Camera looks great. You could already tell that this thing is smudging up a lot. There are a lot of fingerprint smudges right on this iPhone already, but not something I'm concerned about because I'm gonna be throwing a case on this thing in about 5 seconds. I am not gonna be one of those people who walks around without a case for a couple days just to, you know, appreciate the feel of the naked phone in your hand. Not gonna do that. Learned the hard way a couple times that you never go caseless. And of course, I got my screen protector ready to go too. You can never be too careful with your precious new phone. More information on my favorite case and screen protector for the iPhone 10 will be in the video description box below, so be sure to check that out. The difference between the iPhone 7 Plus and the iPhone 10, out of the box, the iPhone 10 obviously feels a lot smaller, weight's pretty much exactly the same. Oh, I'm calling someone here by accident. The biggest difference is not having that bezel on top and bottom and no home button. That's the first thing I'm noticing. And people are worried about there not being some kind of home button on the iPhone 10. This gesture of just swiping up from the bottom seems very natural. I don't think that's going to be an issue. Only time I'm actually concerned about not having a home button is when I'm lying down in bed and like I'm texting sideways. And I, you know, double press the home button to switch an app or double tap to bring it halfway down the screen so it's easier to like manage. But other than that, I don't see no home button being a problem. In many different ways, the iPhone 10 is a huge upgrade from the iPhone 7 Plus. But in certain situations, some might consider it a downgrade as well. If you really like the home button or if you really like Touch ID, you're going to miss both of those things in the iPhone 10. Obviously, Apple has replaced it with what they think is something
something better,
but it's something to consider. I'm super excited to get this thing fully set up, try it out. You will for sure be seeing more videos on this channel reviewing the iPhone X, talking about my favorite features, comparing it to the iPhone 7 Plus. If that's something you're into, don't forget to subscribe or check out my current tech reviews playlist for the iPhone X, which will pop up on a card annotation, top right-hand corner of your screen. Now it's time to go play with this bad girl. I'll catch you guys on the flip side. I'm gonna go set up my Face ID, make sure my face is looking pretty. Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah. X gonna give it to you.